Leading industry reports suggest that 60 to 80% of world's data is gold. Just about every business can benefit from having an archive strategy that maximizes the value of gold data. Modern data archiving is not only about lowering costs for gold data, but it's also about setting up mechanisms so that when you need to put the data to work, you can access it as quickly as your business requirements demand. Hi, I'm Guy Pandey, a product manager for Amazon S3 Glacier. And I'm excited to show you how you can use S3 Glacier to improve your data restore time by up to 85%, enabling you to process restored data faster. Diana Young, a software engineer for S3 Glacier, will also be joining us in a few minutes to demo how you can take advantage of this new S3 Glacier performance improvement. But before we dive deeper into restores, I want to give you a quick overview of Amazon S3 Glacier storage classes. Amazon S3 Glacier is a leader in cloud cold storage and was the first to offer a branded solution in this space over 10 years ago. Amazon S3 has three purpose-built archive storage classes for rarely accessed data. These storage classes range from milliseconds retrieval with S3 Glacier instant retrieval, retrieval in minutes to hours with S3 Glacier Flexible Retrieval, and retrievals in 12 to 48 hours with S3 Glacier Deep Archive. In this short video, we will focus on the S3 Glacier Flexible Retrieval storage class and its standard retrieval tier. Although S3 Glacier Flexible Retrieval and S3 Glacier Deep Archive require a restore request before data can be accessed, our customers tell us that they still want high throughput in case they need to access large portions of their data. This is why in November 2022, we increased the rate at which S3 Glacier accepts restore requests, effectively increasing the potential restore throughput for millions to billions of objects by 10 times. In 2022, customers restored over 2 billion objects in just 1 week. And we've seen even bigger workloads this year as customers take advantage of the additional restore throughput. With more and more customers around the world deriving business value from cold data, we saw a need to give customers the ability to not only get higher throughput, but also get restores starting faster. That's why we are improving S3 Glacier Flexible Retrieval data restore time by up to 85%. This performance improvement is available to you at no additional cost. Faster data restores automatically apply to the standard retrieval tier when using Amazon S3 batch operations. Restores from S3 Glacier Flexible Retrieval now begin to return objects within minutes, enabling you to process restored data faster. With this performance improvement, you can begin processing your machine learning, analytics, media, and backup data within minutes of initiating restores. Now, I'm going to pass it over to Diana to walk you through a quick demo.
Hi, everyone. As Guy mentioned earlier, my name is Diana Young, and I'm a senior software engineer for Amazon S3 Glacier. I've seen firsthand just how important it is for our customers to have fast access to their archive data, which is why I'm so excited to be here with you today discussing the improvement in S3 Glacier data restore time. I'm going to walk you through how you can use S3 batch operations to initiate standard restores. We will initiate restores for 250 objects of 100 megabyte each, totaling 25 gigabyte, that are stored in S3 Glacier Flexible Retrieval. Before the demo, I want to illustrate just how powerful the new improvements are. As you can see from the blue line, the previous restore performance for objects in Glacier Flexible Retrieval initiated via the standard retrieval tier, typically finished within 3 to 5 hours. With the improvements we have made, the same restores will now start within minutes. Let's show you how. Before you start using S3 batch operations, S3 must have permissions to perform S3 batch operations on your behalf. Grant these permissions through an AWS Identity and Access Management role, also known as an IAM role. I've already applied the permissions for this demo. I've also configured S3 event notifications to report when restores start and finish. Now let's go ahead with the demo. You can access batch operations on the Amazon S3 console homepage. Once here, we can start configuring our job by clicking on Create Job. On the next page, select the AWS region in which your bucket is located. Next, you specify the manifest that lists all the objects you want to restore, which can be a list created through an inventory report or your own list of objects. For this demo, I have prepared a CSV file that lists the objects we want to restore. This file lists the bucket name in the first columns and the object keys in the second column. We will click next to the next page. On this page, you will choose the operation type, which in this case is restore. Once selected, a new set of options appear below. Since the objects we want to restore are S3 Glacier Flexible Retrieval, we will select the first option under Restore Source that says Glacier Flexible Retrieval or Glacier Deep Archive. For this relatively small restore, we should easily be able to do what we need with the restored objects within one day. So I'm going to select one day retention. If your data was in the S3 Intelligent Tiering Archive Access tier, you could still benefit from faster restores, but the console won't ask you to specify the number of days to store the restored copy because your objects will be moved to the S3 Intelligent Tiering Frequent Access tier. Finally, since faster restores through S3 batch operations are available on the standard retrieval tier, we will select that option and click Next. On the final page, we will configure two more options. First, we select the destination to write the completion report. Then we choose the IAM role that gives S3 batch operations the permission to perform this operation. When we click Next, it takes us to the review page. We review details. And once everything looks correct, we will click Create Job at the bottom. Now our S3 batch operations restore job will be created. Let's wait for the job to be ready. I will refresh the page, and it looks like it is now ready. Let's select the job and click Run Job at the top. Let's review the details one more time, and once everything is correct, we can confirm by clicking Run Job at the bottom. We'll come back shortly when the job finishes. The job just finished. You can see here that all the objects were initiated at time 7:14. The first object was restored 22 minutes after we initiated the restore, and the last object was restored after 26 minutes. So in summary, we restored 250 objects totaling 25 gigabyte in 26 minutes from S3 Glacier Flexible Retrieval. I'm really excited for you to start using this new feature, and I look forward to hearing about even more ways you are reinventing your business with archived data. Back to you, Guy.
Thank you, Diana. You just saw an example of a workload that can finish in under an hour. Now I want to discuss how you can benefit from faster retrievals with larger jobs. Let's walk through an example. Say you need to generate thumbnails of images stored in S3 Glacier Flexible Retrieval. You have 10 million of these images totaling around 95 terabytes. In the first step, you specify all your objects in an S3 batch operations job and initiate your restore job using the standard retrieval tier. Your restores automatically start within minutes. Now you could invoke AWS Lambda functions across all your objects after all the restores complete. But because restores are starting sooner, you can use that to your advantage to complete the overall workflow faster. So you can configure Lambda to run based on restore event notifications, which can run Lambda function to create a thumbnail as soon as each object completes restoring. This processes the data in parallel to your completing restore job. For large workloads, this can significantly reduce the time it takes to process data end to end. Now, let's summarize the benefits of this S3 Glacier performance improvement. Faster restore speeds on the standard tier are now available using S3 batch operations. Even your large workloads can now benefit from higher throughput available from restores starting in minutes. Many customers tell us that they are keeping the data because they recognize its future potential. To learn even more about how you can maximize the value of your cold storage with Amazon S3 Glacier, scan this QR code to access our new ebook. This ebook will tell you why and show you how Amazon S3 Glacier is helping organizations of all sizes and from all industries transform their data archiving to unlock business value, increase agility, and save on storage costs. Maximizing the value of archived assets to reinvent your business and accelerate your innovation. That is the real value that Amazon S3 Glacier delivers. We are excited to see how you use faster data restores with S3 Glacier to further modernize your data archive. Thank you for your time.